For some reason, it was easy to pick my top 10 films this year. Unlike previous years, I had no trouble whittling it down to 10. In my view, these are the clear-cut best films of 2018, starting with a big blockbuster. At number 10, Black Panther.
Don't freeze.
I never freeze.
Black Panther is that rare superhero movie that exudes excellence in all areas, not just the action. A captivating plot, superb actors, and eye-popping special effects. I don't know about you, but I can't wait for the sequel. At number 10, Black Panther.
You're not going to cure cancer, you're going to prevent cancer.
Yes!
If you're there just to win the prize, you're missing the point of science fair.
No movie this year captured the pure joy of the human spirit more than the National Geographic documentary, Science Fair. 17,000 of the best and brightest competing for that top prize at the international competition. At number 9, the inspirational movie, Science Fair.
Who are we if we can't protect them? We have to protect them.
The best horror film of the year was one with very little dialogue, because if they make any noise at all, a mysterious creature hunts them down and kills them. At number 8, it's a nail-biter, A Quiet Place.
I'm months behind in my rent, and my cat is sick.
It's 4 in the afternoon, and you're drunk.
I'm hardly drunk.
Craig,
no problem.
Melissa McCarthy plays a washed-up writer who turns to forgery to make a living, and turns out she's good at it. McCarthy and Richard E. Grant shine as two of the most unlikable characters on screen this year. At number 7, Can You Ever Forgive Me?
You have become close to Abigail.
She is a viper.
You're jealous.
You must send Abigail away.
I do not want to.
Let's shoot something.
Delicious Deceit is on the menu in 18th century England. Two manipulative women trying to be the favorite of Queen Anne. My favorite period comedy of the year is The Favorite, coming in at number 6.
My mouth to God's ears, I really hate those black rats. And anyone else, really, that doesn't have pure white Aryan blood running through their veins.
I'm happy to be talking to a true white American.
God bless white America.
A black cop goes undercover in the KKK. And this outlandish tale is a true story. Spike Lee at his best once again, bringing this unbelievable story to the screen. My number 5 is Black Klansman.
The vice presidency is a mostly symbolic job. However, if we came to a different understanding.
The way he looks, the way he sounds, the mannerisms, Christian Bale is impeccable, channeling Dick Cheney. This biopic is funny and revealing. At number 4, Vice.
Yeah. Some guy called over here, a doctor. He's looking for a driver. You interested?
I am not a medical doctor. I'm a musician. I'm about to embark on a concert tour in the Deep South. What other experience do you have?
Public relations.
A world-class musician hires a bouncer to drive him and protect him on a concert tour in the Deep South. They forge a friendship along the way. My feel-good movie of the year is my number 3 pick. This is Green Book. The story of a maid working for a wealthy Mexican family is one of the most touching films of the year. In fact, this movie is as close to cinematic masterpiece as you'll get. Number 2 is Roma. And finally, my favorite picture of the year.
I don't sing my own songs.
Why?
I just don't feel comfortable.
Why wouldn't you feel comfortable?
Almost every single person has told me they like the way I sounded, but that they didn't like the way I look.
I think you're beautiful.
And she is so good in this movie. Lady Gaga and Bradley Cooper draw you in from the very start. The most entertaining and emotional movie of the year is my number 1, It's A Star Is Born. Hey, if you haven't seen these films, do yourself a favor, buy a ticket, be entertained. Happy holidays, happy new year, and I'll see you again next year in the movies in the real world.
I'm so fly, you're my old beater. Yeah. And so cold, no heater.
Scrub and Ace High tried to warm up their car to roll into the box. And we gather for this first day of Kwanzaa with a party at Progressive.